Yeah, today concept is test cases concept. Before going to test cases concept, first we will discuss about customer requirements. Customer want this type of application, madam. That application name is login application. He is saying some requirements. Based on the requirements, we need to write the test cases. So login screen should contain first customer requirement. Login screen should contain username, password, fields, connected to is a combo box, and login, clear, cancel buttons. Customer first requirement is login screen should contain username, password, connective fields, login, clear, cancel buttons. That is first requirement. Second requirement, connected to is not a mandatory field. Whenever user requires, he can select a desired database option. Third requirement, after entering username and password, if we click on login button, corresponding page must be displayed. If it is normal user home page, if it is admin user, admin page must be displayed. Fourth requirement, after click on clear button, all the fields must be cleared and cursor should be placed in the username field. After click on cancel button, application must be closed. This is the requirements given by customer. So we can say explicit requirements are FRS document. After giving the customer requirement, business analyst will add some more requirements. First requirement, whenever invoking the login screen, login clear button must be disabled. Login and clear must be disabled. Cancel always enabled. After enter any information into any of the field, clear button must be enabled. After entering username and password, login button must be enabled, and tabbing order must be username, password, connected to fields, login, clear, cancel buttons. So these are the requirements customer given. Okay, login screen should contain username, password, connected to fields, and login, clear, cancel buttons. Connected to is not a mandatory field, but whenever user requires, he can select a desired database option. Upon entering valid username, valid password, and clicking on login button, corresponding page must be displayed. Upon clicking on the clear button, all the information must be cleared, and cursor should be placed in the username field. Upon clicking on the cancel button, application must be closed. Special requirements, these requirements given by business analyst is adding some more requirements. Initially, whenever the login screen is invoked, login clear button must be disabled. Cancel button always enabled. Upon entering username and password, the login button must be enabled. Upon entering any information into any of the field, the clear button must be enabled. The tabbing order must be username, password, connect to, login, clear, cancel buttons. Using these requirements, we can write the test cases. Today concept is test case concept. First, before going to test case concept, first of all, we will discuss about test case template. Each and every software company, they will maintain different test case templates. Maximum same, some fields extra, some fields less. Each and every software company separately, they will maintain test case template. Maximum all the templates will be same. Some companies they will maintain extra fields, some companies will maintain less fields. First, test case ID, TCID. TC means test case ID. Next, test case type. Next, test case description. Expected value, actual value, results. First, test case ID. Next, test case type. Test case description. Expected value. Actual value. And results. Test case ID. We will write 001 or 001 or 01. Test case type. If it is positive, we can write positive. If it is positive, we can write positive. If it is negative, we can write negative. If it is positive, we can write positive. If it is negative, we will write negative. Or if it is GUI, we can write GUI. Test case description. What action we are performing, we will write here. Expected value is nothing but customer requirement. What is customer expecting, we will write here. Actual value means developed application came into testing area, that time that description action we will perform, whatever we will get, we will write here. Okay. Expected value is nothing but customer requirement. Actual value is nothing but developed application came into testing area. Whatever we have in description column, that action we will perform here. Whatever we will get, that is we will write in the actual value column. Next, results. We will compare the expected value with the actual value. If it is both are same, we can give status pass. Otherwise, we can give status fail. Okay, right. This is test case template. Before going to test case template, we will discuss about test cases. And once again, we will discuss about test case template. Today concept is test case. Test case is nothing but it is an idea of test engineer. Test case is nothing but it is an idea of test engineer. Test case is nothing but it is an idea of test engineer. There are two types of test cases. One is GUI test cases, GUI or static test cases. That means GUI test cases or static test cases. Okay, if you want to write the GUI or static test cases, we will follow five guidelines. GUI means without performing any actions on the application, we can write the test cases. Then the type of test cases is known as GUI test cases. Without performing any actions on the application, we can write the test cases. Then the type of test cases is known as GUI test cases or static test cases. One is availability base. Availability. All the buttons are available or not. All the functions are available or not. Based on the customer requirements, all the buttons or the elements are available or not. No need to perform any actions. We can see and say. Next, alignment. Each and every button alignment is properly good or not. No need to perform any actions. Without performing any actions, we can see and say. Next, consistency. Each and every button is consistent with each other or not. So, no need to perform any actions. Without performing any actions, we can see and say. And spelling. Each and every button is spelling is properly or not. No need to perform any actions. Without performing any actions, we can see and say. And color, each and every button color or each and every object color, no need to perform any actions. Without performing any actions, we can see and say. This type of test cases is known as GUI test cases or static test cases. Next, functional test cases. Functional test cases further divided into two types. One is positive second one is negative. One is positive, other one is negative. Positive test cases and negative test cases. Positive means customer want one username field. Customer want one username field. That username field minimum should take 4 characters, maximum 12 characters. He is saying customer requirement is that username field should take minimum 4 characters, maximum 12 characters. If you take between 4 to 12 characters, if you do testing, that is called positive testing. For example, you are taking 4 characters and you are doing testing, that is called positive testing. If you are taking 5 characters, you are doing testing, that is called positive testing. If you are taking 6 characters, you are doing testing, that is called positive testing. If you are taking 12 characters, you are doing testing, that is called positive testing. That is positive testing. These are the valid inputs. Valid inputs. So 4 to 12 characters, between characters, is belongs to valid inputs, valid data. With the help of valid data, if you do testing, that is called positive testing. That is called positive testing. Other than 4 to 12, like 13 characters, 3 characters, and 2 characters, 15 characters, if you do testing, these are the invalid inputs. These are the invalid inputs. With the help of invalid inputs, if you do testing, that is called a negative testing. A test engineer should have negative mindset up, then only he will become a good test engineer. Not only valid inputs, we will take invalid inputs also, we will do testing, that's why that is called negative testing. So we will perform positive testing as well as negative testing also. Okay, a test engineer should have negative mindset up, then only he will become a good test engineer. So minimum we need to take invalid inputs, minimum we need to take one invalid input, so then only we can get the more defects. So a test engineer should have negative mindset up, then only he will become a good test engineer. So positive testing and a negative testing. So we will do positive testing and a negative testing. Today we will discuss test cases concept. All right. Already we know customer requirements. Based on the customer requirements, we will write the test cases. This is a test case template, madam. Test case ID. First one, test case ID. 01 or 001 we will write here. Test case type. There are three types of test cases. One is GUI, second one is positive, third one is negative. Test case description. What action we are performing, we will write here. What action we are performing, we will write here. Expected value. Expected value is means whenever you are doing this action, what customer expecting? What is the customer expectation? We will write here. Okay. This is before developed application came into testing area, we will write up to here. We will write up to here. Whenever developed application came into testing area, that time we will do action on the application. We will do actions on the application. So whatever we are getting, what action we are performing, we will write here. That action we will perform here. So whatever we are getting, we will write in actual value column. Next, we will compare the expected value with the actual value. If it is both are same, we can give the status pass, otherwise we can give the status fail. Okay. Expected value is nothing but customer requirement. Expected value is nothing but customer requirement. Okay. Actual value is nothing but developer application came into testing area. That time we will perform this description action. Whatever we are getting, we will write here. That is actual value. Okay, right. Right. Madam, already we discussed the customer requirements that login object should contain username, password, connect to fields, login, clear, cancel buttons, right?
Yes, sir.
But each and every time if I write here, wait. Yes, this is the test case template, madam. Test case ID, test case type, test case description, expected value, actual value, results. Okay, first test case, GUI test case. GUI means no need to perform any actions on the application. We can write the test cases. Then the type of test cases is known as GUI test cases. Check for the availability of all the object as per the login object tab. Login object tab means I'm giving one name. Each and every time, username is edit box, password is edit box, connect to is combo box, login is button, clear is button, cancel is button. If I write here, it will be lengthy. So that's the reason I'm giving one name is login object tab. Okay, now. Got it, ma?
Yes.
Each and every time if I write, check for the availability of all the object as per the login object, as per the customer. Customer is saying that login object should contain username, password, connect to fields, so login, clear, cancel buttons. So if I write total that matter, it will be lengthy. That's the reason I'm giving one name, login object tab, and I'm attaching the table here only. Wait. You see, login object tab, username text box, password text box, connect to combo box, login button, clear button, cancel button. If I write just like this, so it will be lengthy. That's the reason I am giving one name, login object tab.
Okay. So like we need to prepare this one also?
We need to prepare login object tab also. Based on the customer requirements, we will write here. Right. First test case. Test case ID 1. Test case type GUI. GUI means no need to perform any actions. Check for the availability of all the objects as per the login object tab. Customer expecting all the objects must be available as per the login object tab. And after developer developed application having all the objects are available as per the login object tab. So both are same. We can give the status. Pass. Okay. Next, second test case. Check for the consistency of the all the objects. Expected value. All the objects must be consistent with each other. Actual value. All the objects are consistent with each other. So both are same. We can give the status pass. Third requirement. Third test case. Check for the spellings of the all the objects as per the login object tab. All the objects must be spelled properly as per the login object tab. All the objects are spelled properly. So both are same, pass. Next, fourth test case. Check for the enabled property of login and clear. Login, clear and cancel buttons. Initially, customer requirement is initially login and clear must be disabled and cancel button always enabled. This is the customer requirement. But whenever developer application came into testing area, we will observing login clear and cancel buttons are enabled. All buttons are enabled. So this is not customer requirement. Okay. So both are not matched. We can give the status fail. Next, fifth requirement. Check for the initial position of the cursor. So customer said initially the cursor must be positioned in the username field. Initially the cursor is present in the username field. So both are same. We can give the status pass. Next, sixth test case. Enter some information into username and password field and check for the enabled property of login button. Okay, after entering username and password, that login button must be enabled. That is the customer requirement. Login button is enabled. So both are same. We can give the status pass. Seventh requirement, positive test case. Enter some information into any of the fields and check for the enabled property of clear button. Okay, already customer said enter any information into any of the field, that clear button must be enabled. That clear button is enabled, so pass. Next, enter username password as per the VIT. VIT means valid input table. Correct username, correct password. Valid input table means correct username, correct password. And click on login button. Okay, we are entering correct username, correct password. And we are clicking on login button. Corresponding page must be displayed. If it is normal user, home page. If it is admin user, admin page must be displayed. Corresponding pages are displayed as per the valid input table. So, same, pass. Enter username password as per the valid input table and select a database option and click on login button. Corresponding page must be displayed as per the valid input table. Correct username, correct password we are giving. So, corresponding page must be displayed. Both are same. We can give the status pass. The valid input table also highly I prepared here. You go. Valid input table, correct username, correct password. Invalid input table, wrong username, wrong password. What are the wrong usernames, wrong password? What are the correct usernames, correct passwords? Everything I listed out here in this section. Next, 10th requirement, 10th test case. Enter some information into any of the field and click on the clear button. Whenever you click on clear button, all the fields must be cleared and cursor should be placed in the username field. And actual value. All the fields are cleared, but cursor is not positioned in the username field. So, based on the customer requirement, all the fields must be cleared and cursor should be placed in the username field. But, actual value means developed application came into testing area, we will click on clear button. Whatever we are getting, we will write here. So, all the fields are cleared, but cursor should not place in the username field. So, this is not correct. So, fail. And, click on the cancel button. Login screen should be closed. Login screen is closed. So, pass. Next, 11th requirement. 12th one. Check for the tabbing order of all the objects. Customer said, tabbing order must be as follows. Username, password, connect to, login, clear, cancel. Tabbing order as follows. Username, password, connect to, login, clear, cancel. So, both are same. We can give the status pass. And negative test case. Enter username password as per the invalid input table. That means wrong username, wrong password. And click on login button. Corresponding error message must be displayed. Corresponding error message is not displayed. So fail. 14th one. Enter some information only into the username field. And check for the enabled property of login button. Only username we are giving. We are not giving any password. So, login button must be disabled. Login button is enabled. So, fail. Enter some information into the password field. And check for the enabled property of login button. We are giving only password. We are not giving any username. So, directly we are giving only password. That time, that login button must be disabled. Login button is enabled. So, fail. This is test cases. Based on the customer requirements, application is behaving or not. We will do testing. So, we will write test cases. After writing test cases, we will execute. We will execute means, based on the customer requirements, application is behaving or not. We will check. Okay. This is normal test cases, madam. Now, we will discuss general test cases. Now, for example, keyboard. I'm writing test cases. Check enter button is available or not. Check space button is available or not. Check control button is available or not. Check shift button is available or not. Check caps lock available or not. Check tab button is available or not. Check numerical lock available or not. Check insert button is available or not. Check delete button is available or not. Check end button is available or not. Check page up and page down buttons available or not. Check up and down arrows available or not. Check all the numerical keys available or not. Check all the keys, character keys available or not. So, check backspace available or not. We will write the test cases. Now, I am giving one white paper. Now I am giving only one white paper. Now tell me test cases for white paper. White paper. Just normal test cases. Check. Now I will write first test case. Check. Just general test cases. Different ideas. Check. It is ruled or unruled. Check. It is ruled or unruled. Now tell me. Check. It is ruled or unruled. Next test case. Check. Check. It is pure white or not. Check. It is pure white or not. Check. Both sides empty or not. You need to tell madam. Check. Both sides are empty or not. Check size of the paper. Check quality of the paper. Next. Check. It is. Check. It is. We can write. Check. It is anything written on it. Anything written on it. Written on it. Check. It is lettered or white paper. Check. It is ready to write or not. Different ideas. Just for general knowledge purpose we are discussing. Differently we need to think. Okay, a test engineer should have different ideas. Negative and positive both. Check. It is ready to write or not. Check. It is. Check. It is wet condition or dry condition. Wet or dry condition. Check. It is allowing all the pens are not. Next. Check. It is. Check. Check. It is. Check. It is having any holes. Check. It is rough or neat. Check. It is rough or neat. Next. Check. It is dead inside any corner. Check. It is. Check. It is. Is it durable or not? Check. It is any watermarks. Check it is any watermarks. Still, tell me, madam. Check it is. We can fold or not. Still. Still, tell me, madam, madam, we need to think differently. This is the idea, different ideas. Like we can write many test cases, madam. If you think differently, you can get number of test cases. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Okay. These are the test cases, madam. Your homework is you need to write just like this format, you need to write the test cases for. Just silly. One is lift, home, lift, home, and kitchen. Same format only. Check it is R. We can use two words. Check it. Check it is R. Verify. We can use these two words. Verify. Is it ruled or unruled? Verify. It is pure white or not. Verify. Both sides empty or not. Verify. Check size. Verify. Size. Verify. Quality of the paper. Okay. We can use check it is or check or verify. We can use the both words. Your homework is you need to write the test cases for lift, home, kitchen. Wherever you go, madam, if it is manual testing, you need to write only test cases, madam. First of all, we need to understand the customer requirements. After understanding the customer requirement, how to write the test cases, this is our duty, this is our life. In our life, we will write only, first of all, we need to understand the requirements. After understanding the requirements, how to write the test cases. If you know these things, you can work with any software company, madam. This is very, very important concept, okay? Write the test cases and do. If you comfortable with this test cases, tomorrow I will show you real-time test cases. Okay. After finishing test cases concept, then only we can move to other concept. Otherwise, once again, we will repeat this test cases concept only. Why? Because this is very, very, very important. If you are working with any software company, any project, first of all, we should know only one thing, how to understand the customer requirements. And after understanding the requirements, how to write the test cases. This is only one-day training, madam. Okay. Just you should concentrate on only test cases concept. Okay. Already I gave you already we discussed customer requirements. Okay. Based on the customer requirements, today we wrote test cases. Okay, madam. This is today class. Tomorrow also we have class, India time 6 p.m. Okay. I will send you this concept. Wait.